The sexualization of women within music has been evident dating back for decades, more so the stereotyping of genders for generations. Females have always been hypersexualized within the media. Within this text, I will be exploring why females are treated this way through music videos and how women are growing to alter these demeaning views. Mary Wollstonecraft, an author in the 18th century, was the first notable figure in the fight for equality amongst sexes. In 1792, she wrote a Vindication of the Rights of Women, where she argues women are not inferior to men but only appear to be, as they are not given access to education and the opportunity to prove themselves. Instead of viewing women as ornaments to society or property to be traded in marriage, she maintains they are human beings deserving of the same fundamental rights as men. Starting with comparing music videos, both of the same R&B / mainstream genre from different decades, it's evident that female representation is finally evolving into more than just being eye candy for men. For example, as we see in the music video for Woman by Doja Cat 2021, the men in this video are the submissive, whilst the females appear to take the dominant role, already breaking free from Angela McWobbie's feminism theory. In this theory, she says the media portray women to be weak, submissive to men, have traditional roles such as nurses or mothers, etc. Yet Doja is taking herself out of this representation by creating a strong, independent role projected through her music video.
Your Majesty, we have a problem. They're trying to seize your throne.
Take me to them now.
In the intro, the black female lead is addressed as the queen and is going to take back your throne from the men, which symbolises reality as women are becoming more and more independent, racially diverse and powerful within the media. Although Laura Mulvey's male gaze is used throughout where Doja is performing in minimal clothing, it feels empowering to see women dancing amongst other powerful women rather than just being used for male gaze. If you were to watch her other music videos, there's a pattern of her portrayal as a sexually alluring character. Although male gaze is evident through her character, instead of it being a traditional alluring to men and performing for men etiquette, she is using this male gaze to her advantage by creating a sexually powerful image of herself, again linking in with Angela McWobbie's theory. Angela believes that in some media texts, women are shown in more powerful sexual roles and suggests this could be a good thing. This is where controversy aroused, as other feminists argue that as they believe that the suggestion is demeaning to women. In an alternative viewpoint, Anja believes that some representations empower women as sexually powerful. Why is this? Women in male-dominated videos of this genre are often referred to as hoes and bitches, etc., and most commonly dressed in next to nothing in these male gaze media texts, which brainwashes the audience into linking women wearing skimpy outfits with these derogatory terms. In Albert Bandura's social learning theory, he states that children observe the people around them behaving in various ways, which was illustrated during the famous Bobo doll experiment, Bandura 1961. Furthermore, if audiences are growing up consuming the media, such as these outdated gender norms, they will grow up linking females in little clothing with believing that by wearing little clothes, they are worth less and conform to these belittling terms. This proved to be evident in Akon's music video for I Wanna Love You 2006, as the main premise of this video is degrading women, wearing expensive jewellery and dancing in front of expensive cars. Through this video, we get the impression that women are just being objectified as sex objects and not people, as whole song is based on just how he wants to have sex with the women. The ladies are all wearing similar outfits of lingerie and dancing on chairs, and this is where the degrading names come in, as men want the attractive women, yet whenever the women are mentioned, it's just about what they possess sexually or their figures. Therefore, this gives the impression sex is all that females are wanted for, and this relates back to Angela's female theory. Male gaze is obviously the main appealing point in Akon's outdated video, using women in cars to keep the target audience of primarily men interested in the video, once again referencing Albert Bandura's social learning theory. This being said, it's becoming more evident slowly through younger generations having more open mindsets towards other topics, such as LGBTQ+ community and race, as it's very much more so frowned upon to have negative opinions on these matters, as opposed to older generations where it's completely normalised. Whilst female empowerment is on the rise, we are still very far from equality. The rates of sexual assault are on the rise across the globe. Women tend to be paid on average 17% less than male co-workers, and the US is currently the 10th most dangerous place in the world for a woman. The list goes on. In conclusion, although women are slowly breaking free from their gender role stereotypes through music videos and modern media texts, needless to say, it is unbelievable that arguments dating back as far as 1792 are still just as relevant in the 21st century, and equality is still very far on the horizon.